Implementing Busy Mobile App. In this presentation, we'll discuss about implementing and using Busy Mobile App. Busy Mobile App is an Android-based app using which user can access company's data. Prerequisites for using or implementing Busy Mobile App are: first, user must have active Busy license subscription. Second, you must configure Busy Data Exchange Platform Utility, that is BDEP service, on your computer on the company which you want to use. Next, internet connection is required only if you are using mobile app on internet mode, and if you are using a mobile app on internet or LAN mode, then it is necessary that the company must be open or logged in on your computer system before using mobile app. Steps required for implementing Busy Mobile App are: Step 1, configure in Busy. Step 2, port forwarding and opening. Step 3, download and install Busy Mobile App on your Android phone. And step 4, configure Busy Mobile App and start using it. We'll discuss all these steps in detail, starting with our step number 1, that is configure in Busy. First of all, you need to configure certain configuration in Busy. For this, we'll open a company in Busy. We'll go to Administration, Configuration, Features Options, General tab. In the General tab, at the bottom, you can see various options are appearing, in which first of all, we'll specify yes in the allow Busy to run as web server option. After that, next option is web server port number, which will be filled automatically. If you want, you can change this port number. Then is enable Busy Data Exchange Platform BDEP. You will specify yes in this option also, as I have mentioned earlier also that it is necessary to configure BDEP. After specifying yes in this option, a configuration button will appear. On clicking the configuration button, you need to specify the BDEP ID and password of your company. Here on the screen, you can see BDEP ID, password and other details are appearing, as we have already created a BDEP ID for the company. If you want, you can create a BDEP ID using the create new ID option. However, for more details on BDEP, you can view our video uploaded on YouTube for the BDEP utility. After configuring the BDEP ID, next option is enable Busy Mobile App. Very important, you need to specify yes in this option to enable Busy Mobile App in the company. On specifying yes, a configuration button will appear. On clicking the configuration button, an options for mobile app window will appear, in which you need to enable the enable mobile app for parties option if you want to give mobile app access rights to your parties. That is, on enabling this option, your parties can also have access to mobile app and can view certain reports related to them. Click save button to save this configuration. Now we will specify yes in the mobile app option for the parties to whom we want to give the mobile app access rights. We'll go to masters, account, modify option. We'll open a party in modify mode. Here at the bottom, you can see an option allow access to mobile app. You'll specify yes in this option if you want to give mobile app access rights to this party. On specifying yes in the option, a config button will appear. On clicking the config button, a party mobile app details window will appear, in which you'll specify the username and password for the party. This particular username and password the party will use to log into the mobile app. Specify yes in the allow stock status option if you want that party can view the stock status report also. Otherwise, if you do not want to give this right, then you can specify no in this option. Click save button to save the account master. Now we'll discuss the users menu. On clicking the users menu, under administration menu, you can see two options are appearing: busy users and mobile app users. Busy user is our regular busy user we have created in busy. Here we are opening a user profile for a sub user in modify mode. Here an option allow access to mobile app is appearing. You can specify yes in this option if you want to give mobile app access to this particular user also. That means this particular user Shyam can access mobile app. Next is mobile app users. This option will appear only after enabling the mobile app option in the company. Mobile app users are those users that you will create, and these users can only use the mobile app and cannot work in busy. So if you want to create certain users that can use the mobile app only, then you can do so by using this mobile app users option. Specify the username and password for the mobile app user. Specify the password again and give various rights to the user, like user can view bills receivable, bills payable, account ledger, day book, stock status report. And then the master's right, you can specify the range of masters that the user can have access to. In the account master, you can specify one particular account, group of account, all accounts or selected accounts. Here we are selecting the selected accounts option. On selecting this option, we have specified the group as sundry debtors, and in the sundry debtors group we have selected only four parties. That means we have given rights of these four parties to this particular user. Next, for the item master, we have given rights for all the items, that is user can view details of all the item masters. Click save button to save the user profile menu. Now is our step 2, port forwarding and opening. This will be required only if you are using internet mode in Busy Mobile app. For details on port forwarding and opening, you can refer to our video port forwarding and opening uploaded on YouTube. Next is step 3, download and install Busy Mobile app on your Android phone. That is, we'll download the Busy Mobile app and install it on your mobile. We'll go to Play Store, we'll type the keyword Busy app. Here you can see Busy app is appearing. Click this option, click the install button, then accept button. You can see on the screen Busy app has been installed. You can open the app from here itself, or on the main screen of your computer you can see an icon of Busy app has started appearing. Next is our step 4, configure Busy Mobile app and start using it. That is, we'll configure the Busy Mobile app and start using it. Double click the Busy Mobile app icon. For discussing further, we'll like to specify that in the Busy Mobile app there are two modes, company mode and party mode, and in the company mode further there are two modes, internet online mode and offline mode. First of all, we'll discuss the online, that is internet mode under company. We'll go to current profile option. Here four options are appearing: configure new, switch profile, modify profile and delete profile. Configure new to create a new profile. Switch profile, if you have multiple profiles then you can switch between them. Modify profile option to modify any existing profile, and delete profile option to delete a particular profile. We have selected the configure new option. Here in the select mode option, we'll select the mode as company mode, connection type as internet, then we'll specify the BDDAP ID of the company. BDAP ID, you remember we have already configured in Busy. BDAP ID of the company will specify here, and then we'll specify the username and password, and click the authenticate and save button to authenticate these details. Once these details have been verified, now you can start working in the Busy Mobile app. Here on the screen you can see various options are appearing. First option is of import masters, that is we can import masters in mobile app. On clicking this options, we have selected the all masters option and click the continue button. Clicking the continue button, it's showing a message that all the masters are imported in your mobile app. Next, we will view the reports. On clicking the report option, you can see account ledger, daybook, stock status, bills receivable and bills payable option are appearing. We'll click the account ledger option, specify the party name, specify the starting date and ending date, and click the generate report button to view the account ledger of the party. You can double click on any particular option also to drill down report to further level. You can see on the screen we have double clicked on an entry and it's showing further details of the entry also. Next, we will discuss offline mode under company. Under offline mode, first you need to import masters and transactions to your mobile using LAN mode. After that only you can switch to offline mode and view reports. Also make sure wireless network is same on your computer and mobile, that is you are using same Wi-Fi connection on your computer and mobile. Again, we'll go to configure new option. Now we'll select the connection type as LAN, specify the BDAP ID of the company, specify the username and password. Now we'll specify the IP address and port. You can pick the IP address and port from the available LAN IPs. Click the pick from available LAN IPs button and you can select the required IP address and port number. However, you can also pick the port number and IP address details from Busy itself. For this, you'll go to Busy. Under help menu, you will select the get network card IP option and Busy will show you the IP address and port number. After specifying the IP address and port number, click authenticate and save button for authentication. Once authentication is done successfully, now you'll import the masters by clicking the import masters button. Here we have imported all the masters. Next is import transactions option. One thing to remember here is that you can import only last 100 transactions within the specified date range. If on a particular date there exist more than 100 transactions, then those transactions will be imported. Otherwise, last 100 transactions will be imported within the date range. On clicking the import transactions button, a message is appearing: import transactions for ledger, bill receivable, bills payable. You can select the required option and further specify the details. Next, we have selected the import transactions for bills receivable option and for all accounts. Click the import bills receivable button to import transactions related to bills receivable. So you can import transactions as per your requirement, that is you want to import transactions for ledger or bills receivable payable. Now we'll select the offline mode option. You can see on selecting the offline mode option, import masters and import transactions buttons are deactivated. Here you can view the reports. On clicking the report button, further we have selected the account ledger option, specified the party starting date, ending date, and on the screen you can view the account ledger. Now we will discuss the party mode. Till now we have discussed the company mode. Now we'll discuss the party mode. We'll click the configure new option in the mobile app. Here now we'll select the mode as party mode. Connection type is internet. Specify the BDEP ID of company and party login credentials. If you remember, we have specified the same username and password with the party while configuring the party. It has to specify the same username and password that is tagged with it. Now click the authenticate and save button. Now you can see on the screen, first screen is appearing wherein party can change the password. If the party wants to change the password as specified busy, then it can do so by using the change password option. Next option is of reports. Party can view reports. Here on clicking the reports option, you can see account ledger, bills receivable, bills payable, stock status. Stock status option is appearing only because we have enabled the allow stock status option for party also. Otherwise, if we have not given rights for stock status, party would not be able to view the stock status. Here party is viewing the account ledger. You can see on the screen account ledger is appearing. At the bottom, a help and support button is provided. On clicking this button, you can view the help documents related to the mobile app and download the same also. So this is the whole process of using and implementing Busy mobile app. Hope after going through this presentation, you would be able to easily implement Busy mobile app. Thanks for watching. For more videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel.